Five more reasons why Jehovah's Witnesses do not believe Jesus is God, the Creator. Three Bible facts need to be mentioned in order to understand the rest of the information. Fact 1. Know that Jehovah is God. It is He that has made us. Psalm 100, verse 3. Fact 2. There are different kinds of natures. For example, divine nature, almighty, mighty. Human nature, weak, need rest. Immortal nature, incorruptible. Mortal nature, corruptible. And sin nature, disobedient and rebellious. The nature in heaven is divine. Anointed Christians, adopted sons of God, will be sharers in divine nature in heaven. Jesus shared in human nature on earth. Fact 3. Because Jehovah is God, all of His sons in heaven are called gods, mighty ones, godlike ones, begotten gods, because their nature is divine. Divine nature makes God God, but makes His angelic sons godlike, mighty ones. Thus, Michael the archangel is a god. The angel Gabriel is a god. Satan is a fallen angel, a fallen god. So there is no denying that as God's son, Jesus is a god. The question is Jesus Almighty God, the Creator? As you can see, more than divine nature is required to be God, the Creator. 1. Jesus never received sacred service, sacred worship in the Bible. Philippians 2:10 and 11, that in the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth, and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. In the Bible, King Jesus received, quote, worship or non-sacred service, for example, honor, praise, and glory, obeisance, showed reverence, prayed to when visibly present, bowed down to. Even human kings like Solomon and David received, quote, worship, honor. Some have argued that Peter and John refused worship from angels and men. Even the angels refused worship from men, but Jesus did not. It is because Jesus is no ordinary king. He is God's son and God's chief agent of life. As God's chief agent of life, worship is directed to God through Jesus. For example, when we bow our knees in prayer to God, we have to end in the name of Jesus or God will not accept the prayer. Worship directed to God through God's other angelic sons, through anointed Christians like Peter and John, or material objects of devotion like icons and crucifixes is sin. Why? Because God did not authorize worship to be directed to Him through them. If worship is directed to God through anything or anyone else other than Jesus, it is idolatry. Worship without the quotation mark, sacred service, devotion, adoration must be rendered to God alone. For example, silent prayers addressed to one not visibly present can only be given to God. Sacrificial offerings are made to God. For example, Jesus, the Lamb of God, was provided for us by God to sacrifice and use as an offering to Him. Devotional songs and praises are addressed to God alone. 2. Jesus is not eternally begotten, also known as eternal generation. John 8:57 and 58. Then the Jews said to Him, "You are not yet 50 years old, and you have seen Abraham?" "Truly, truly, I tell you," Jesus declared, "before Abraham was born, I am." Jesus' reply had to do with age, the length of His existence. Before Abraham existed, Jesus has been in existence in heaven. Trinitarians try to connect John 8:58 with Exodus 3:14, where in their translations, God, who is eternal, refers to Himself as the I am, which has to do with identity, not age. Some translations will try to capitalize the A in am at John 8:58, so it will appear as though Jesus is describing Himself in the same manner as God did in Exodus 3:13 and 14. John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Jesus was begotten before He came to earth, but not eternally. He had a beginning. Jesus is the firstborn, eldest of all creation. Eternally begotten is a lie made up by supporters of the Trinity. Trinitarians will argue that begotten does not mean created or generated. It does not matter what they think begotten means, because God is not begotten. If they claim begotten means unique, the only one of its kind, then God the Father is not unique, the only one of his kind, nor is the Holy Spirit for that matter, for neither is begotten. Only a spirit creature, an angel, could be made into a human creature, a man. Jesus is a creature, a created being. Creature worship is sin. 3. Jesus is not the same kind of God as God, his Father. Isaiah 9:6. For a child is born to us, a son is given to us, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Isaiah lists the prophetic title names by which the Messiah would be identified. For example, Mighty God. Jesus Christ is prophetically called El Gibor, Mighty God, not El Shaddai, God Almighty. All of God's sons are called gods. They are all mighty ones, thus mighty gods. Here in Isaiah, Mighty God is capitalized because it is a title name. To be El Shaddai, God Almighty, Jesus would have to be the designer of creation, eternal, unbegotten, eternally immortal, and the Holy Spirit must originate from him. John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Since the New Covenant referred to as the NT was written in Greek, we will look at two Greek manuscripts to find out what was really said at John 1:1. The emphatic diaglot containing the original Greek text published by Fowler and Welsh reads at John 1:1, In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with the God, and a God was the Word. This was in a beginning with the God. In their Bible translations, Trinitarian translators change a God was the Word to the Word was God, which has a completely different meaning from the original text. Another way to figure out what kind of God Jesus is at John 1:1 is to look at John 1:18 in the Greek interlinear at BibleHub.com. There it reads, God no one has seen ever yet. The only begotten God, the one being in the bosom of the Father, he has made him known. So John 1:1 did not mean Jesus is the unbegotten God, rather he is the begotten God, to be specific, the only begotten God. When referring to God's sons as gods, it can be written as begotten gods, lowercase g, quote, gods, uppercase g, or gods, lowercase g, so-called gods, lowercase g, and mighty gods, lowercase g. Matthew 1:23, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Jesus' title name Emmanuel simply meant God was with mankind by means of his only begotten Son. Jehu means Jehovah is he. Was Jehu Jehovah God incarnate? Why did God not call his son Jehu? Note, father and son have some title names in common, but they have different meanings. For example, who is the only begotten son? Or who is the only begotten father? Who is the unbegotten father? Who is the only begotten Lord? Who is the unbegotten Lord? Who is the only begotten Savior? Who is the unbegotten Savior? Who is the only begotten God? Who is the unbegotten God? Definition of unbegotten. 1. Not begotten. 2. Having never been generated. Self-existent, eternal. 4. Jesus is not co-equal with God his Father. John 5:23. So all may honor the Son just as they honor the Father. Whoever does not honor the Son does not honor the Father who sent him. Was Jesus demanding worship? No, at Luke 10:16, Jesus said, He who rejects me rejects the one who sent me. Honoring Jesus means to show him the same deep respect and obedience we would God his Father. So when Jesus said prayers are to be addressed to the Father, those who disobey and address prayers to the Son and or to the Holy Spirit are dishonoring Jesus and God who sent him. When Jesus said to Satan, It is Jehovah your God. You must worship and him alone should you serve. Those who disobey and worship either of God's sons, Jesus God's firstborn son, or Satan his archenemy son, are dishonoring Jesus and God who sent him. John 5:18. This is why the Jews were seeking all the more to kill him, because not only was he breaking the Sabbath, but he was even calling God his own Father, making himself equal with God. The Antichrist Jews in Jesus' day falsely accused him of trying to make himself equal to God, because he called God his own Father. Adam could also claim God as his own Father. Would Adam be making himself equal to God? In numerous scriptures, Jesus said his Father was greater than he. They also lied when they claim he broke the Sabbath. Jesus kept the Sabbath. 5. Jesus is distinct from God his Father. They are a separable one. John 10:30-33. I and the Father are one. The Jews picked up stones again to stone him. Jesus answered them, I have shown you many good works from the Father. For which of them are you going to stone me? The Jews answered him, It is not for a good work that we are going to stone you, but for blasphemy, because you, being a man, make yourself God. If Jesus had claimed he was God, as Binitarians and Trinitarians claim, he would be guilty of blasphemy. However, that is not what Jesus meant. When Jesus said, I and the Father are one, he meant in purpose. They are in union with each other. In prayer to God his Father, Jesus prayed that his disciples be one, just as he and his Father are one. There's nothing mysterious about Christian oneness, nor is there anything mysterious about the oneness of the Father and the Son. There are many other scriptures Binitarians and Trinitarians will misinterpret in their attempt to make Jesus co-equal to Almighty God Jehovah, the God and Father of the Lord Jesus Christ. Question, what kind of God do Jehovah's Witnesses believe God's Spirit sons, including Jesus, are? A. God Almighty, God, G-O-D, all caps, the unbegotten God, El Shaddai. B. Begotten gods, so-called gods, quote gods, lowercase g gods, mighty gods. B. Begotten gods, so-called gods, quote, gods, lowercase g gods, mighty gods. Question, what kind of worship do Jehovah's Witnesses believe Jesus, a quote, God, receives in the Bible? A. Non-sacred worship or, quote, worship. B. Sacred worship. A. Non-sacred worship or, quote, worship. Question, true or false, when the Greek word for worship, proskynio, is applied to creatures, for example, Jesus, King David, and Abraham's business associates, the New World Translation translates it as obeisance, because worship belongs only to God. True. Which of the following do Jehovah's Witnesses believe best describes Almighty God? A. The Father who created everything, the designer, the creator, maker. Eternally immortal, unbegotten, eternally existing, has no equal, the source, emanator, of the Holy Spirit. B. The Son, through whom all things are made, maker, his immortal life a gift, begotten, created, has equals, peers, the hand by which all things are made, maker, unbegotten, eternally existing. D. All of the above. A. The Father who created everything, the designer, creator, maker, eternally immortal, unbegotten, eternally existing, the source, emanator of the Holy Spirit. Question, true or false, Jehovah's Witnesses believe angels are called, quote, gods or gods, because they have divine nature? True. Question, who or what do Jehovah's Witnesses believe Binitarians and Trinitarians are worshiping when they worship the second and third persons in their Godhead? A. God's begotten generated Son and God's figurative hand, God's power in action. B. God the Son and God the Holy Spirit. A. God's begotten generated Son and God's figurative hand, God's power in action. What you should remember from this diagram: Jehovah God begets. God spelled with a capital G, or G-O-D, all capitals, begets gods, humans, and animals. Gods, spelled with a capital G, or gods, lowercase angels, were not created to beget. Humans beget humans, animals beget animals. Beget, verb. 2. Give rise to, bring about. For example, violence only begets more violence. Synonyms: cause, give rise to, bring about, create, produce, generate, engender, spawn.